Okay, welcome to ETN News. We're looking at the earthquakes, and you can see how Hawaii is really ramped up. I mean, it just keeps ramping up over and over. This all can't go on without something happening. So you need to be careful on the island if you live on the big island. You need to be extra careful and always be alert. You can see what we got going on out around the shelf and over here on this side, got a 3.9 west northwest of Hawaii in Ocean View, 7.1 miles deep. And then over from Mauna Kea, a 2.1, 1.7 miles deep. These are still going right out to this slump, coming right in with it off the Kilauea fault. As you see all the activity, always be prepared over there. That's not looking good. I mean, anything could happen. I mean, it could take the island back, the volcano. We never know what the next day brings. All right, now here is Alaska, and not much going on in Alaska. Just all kinds of small activity. We only have two up this way. It's 2.5 and greater. This is a 2.7 and a 3.3. Let's go on down here and check this out. We got one small one on Mount Rainier. And down through here, we don't have much going on. You zoom in, it's not much. It scatters out a whole lot, long ways. Here's the fault that we were talking about coming down to Las Vegas. It is still active. Let me zoom that in a little bit. You can see it coming down through here. Okay, around Anza is starting to pick up on activity a little bit. We've had some large activity down there before. And around Little Lake coming down to Searles Valley. Let's see if we got any on the Garlock Fault. We have to turn our faults on here. Okay, we got two Garlock Fault. A 1.2, 2.6 miles deep, and a 0.9, 5.6 miles deep. Still got activity around Lamont. A lot of drilling going on up here. Geothermal. Look how this is coming in, though. It don't show no faults right through here. But like I was telling you before, there's a fault line that comes across through here, and it comes over and right down toward Las Vegas. All right, see what else we have. One small one in Yellowstone. 0.6. All right, over in Texas. Now we can look at Texas here and check something out here in a moment. Let's go look at a few other earthquakes. This is just a 3.0, 4.1 miles deep. That is south of New Mexico City. But anyway, let's go over here and check this out. All right, we got these coming down, going right into the Cascadia. 22 hours ago, 3.2, west of Port Hardy, British Columbia. And we got some shaking going on. That is an hour and 22 minutes ago. In between, well, that is northwest of New York and southwest of Upper New York. All right, anyway, 2.5 and greater. Here's what we have, the 3.0 in Texas, 2.8, southwest of Walker, 3.4 miles deep. Now they're both 2.8s. And that one is 5.4 miles deep. This one down here in Mexico, 3.011 kilometers deep. Let's get all this cut off out of my way. Oh, we just had a 5.5 in South America. Looks like Argentina. And that is 166.1 miles deep. And we got some other earthquakes over here. 121.7 miles deep. A 4.7 around Tonga. Around Fiji region, a 4.4, 323 miles deep. And then we did got this one here, I think, 161.1 miles deep around Indonesia. Now, Hawaii is right in the middle. The continents are moving. North America is pushing against the Pacific plate. And it's doing a twist. You know, the top end will be going this way. The bottom end will be going this way. North America is going that way and up. Hawaii is right in the middle of all this. And we're expecting large activity in the next couple days. Hawaii, you got to be prepared. You're right in the middle of all of this. And we had a 5.2 on the southern mid-Atlantic ridge, 6.2 miles deep. Now over here, this here is the hazard map, the seismic zones. Now I'm looking at the last 30 days. This is not 24 hours. I just want to show you something, point some things out. All right, now these are the seismic zones. This one up here in Boston, it's had a quake. All these have had quakes the last 30 days. This one here I've been watching for a long time. We never see any activity down here in this seismic zone. And let's go down, see where that's at. Okay, around, let me see, Ladson ain't in the zone. This is 120%. It's trying to get it to where you can see some names. Goose Creek. Some of that's in there, but not all of it. You got Summersville, Northern Charleston. Northern Charleston is all in it. That's the only one that I haven't been seeing activity from. Sorry about the white flashes. And you can see the New Madrid. It's got a lot of activity right in the New Madrid. And over here in Tennessee, around Dillsboro and Rutledge. And this is a seismic zone. And Chatsworth, Georgia. That is south-southwest of Chatsworth, Georgia. These others are in Tennessee. Okay, and we got this over here. Let's take a look at this. Now you're going to see some white flashes. This is Mexico. Texas. And you can see right here, it's not even in the seismic zone. This is around south of Nixon, Texas. Christine. East of Christine, Texas, and west southwest of Falls City. And you can see right here, this is not in the seismic zone. It's just a 4%, but 2% chance of ever getting an earthquake. These are seismic zones. They can really hold some large quakes. This one down here, we had a 5.1. That was the last 30 days in Texas. It's not even in the major seismic zones. And up in here in Oklahoma, it's going all the way out. And even a few, which now they're blasting on the outside of the seismic zone. Now over here, this is the West Coast, last 30 days. You can see all the activity that's come down the Juan de Fuca Fault. You can see the all the activity, and a lot of these they didn't show, but they show up on here when you look at them in the last 30 days. A lot of these are on the Cascadia subduction zone, and there's a whole lot more coming off the Gordia Escarpment and the Mendocino. And this is Alaska. Look how we backed up. We watched it back up several times in the last 30 days. You got to look at all this, what's going on. Now over here in Hawaii, now you're going to see some white flashes. I'm going to zoom in. Look at all that. All the way around the island. Be prepared over here. Just don't go on for no reason. It may calm down, but it will ramp right back up because we don't see movement for nothing. And we're still looking for a large quake. And we're just looking for it for 3 to 5 days. So we still got a few days left on that, watching for that. So still watch it, starting at the Cascadia. And the reason I say starting at the Cascadia is that's where I see the pressure pushing on, pushing up against the North American continent, the plate coming through here on the Cascadia. You can see the pressure building on it. And when it pushes up against it, this side sometimes will give first. So we got to watch all the way around the Ring of Fire when we see something like that coming. Because we don't know, it could leave the Cascadia and come on down. Or if it hits the Cascadia and doesn't come on down, or put pressure over here, you know, make it hit over here somewhere. If it doesn't do that, then it will be a very large quake. Because we can see the pressure building, and when we do, we usually see a 6.0 or 7 plus hit somewhere on the Ring of Fire, around the main plates. Down here, the Cocoa plates, still looks pretty rough. Anyway, I'll see you all in the next updates. Everybody stay safe, and still watch for that large quake. And we'll be watching.